Dear students, today I would like to discuss about Hayes bridge. This bridge is nothing but a modification of Maxwell's inductance bridge. Okay, so this bridge is used to measure the self-inductance of an unknown inductor. Okay, so this is the unknown inductor. This will be the unknown inductor. So here we will connect unknown inductor, and this is R2, which will be very available at different multiples, and this is R3, and this is the R4, and this is the C4. These are also variables. We can vary all these elements. Okay, so R2, R4, and C4 can be varied. Okay, so here R2, R3, and R4, these are the non-inductive resistance, and this is Rx is nothing but internal resistance of this impedance or this inductance Lx, and C4 is a standard capacitor which will be available at different multiples. So when we will switch on the supply E, at that time what will happen? Power will be on, and this is a detector. Generally this detector is nothing but a headphone. So in this headphone there will be huge sound. Okay, sound will be very high. So what we will do to balance the circuit, R2, R4 and C4 we will vary. Okay, so by varying R2, R4 and C4, we will try to make the detector's sound as minimum as possible. So when balance will be achieved, then we will observe that this detector or this headphone is giving very low sound, means small sound or zero sound. So at balance conditions, what will happen? At balance condition, what will happen? That ZX Z4 equal to Z2 Z3. So what is ZX? ZX is nothing but RX plus J omega LX. And what is Z4? Z4 is nothing but R4 plus J by omega C4. So this will become minus. Okay, so this is R2. Z2 is nothing but R2, and Z3 is nothing but R3. So here it will be R2 R3. So if you will do multiplication and imaginary equal to both side, equating imaginary and real parts, then we will get Rx equal to and Lx equal to. So Rx we will get omega square R2 R3 R4 C4 square by 1 plus omega square C4 square R4 square. Okay, and we will get Lx equal to R2 R3 C4 by 1 plus omega square C4 square R4 square. Okay, this we will get. So these two equations are very important. So when balance, we will the point at which we will get balance. So for what values of R2, R4 and C4 we are getting minimum sound of this detector. Okay, it means for what values of R2, R4 and C4 and R3 we are getting the balance conditions. So substitute all these values in these two equations, so we will get Rx and Lx. That means we will get Zx. Okay, so if you will see the quality factor, is then what will happen? Quality factor we will get. So quality factor Q is nothing but XL by Rx. So if you will substitute, then we will get 1 by omega R4 C4. So Rx in terms of quality factor, what we will get? Omega square R2 R3 R4 C4 square by 1 plus 1 by Q whole square. Okay, similarly we will get Lx equal to R2 R3 C4 by 1 plus 1 by Q whole square. Okay. So if this value is high, so we can neglect this one. If this Q value is low, we can not neglect this one. Okay. So from this expression, it is clear that Hayes bridge is only used for measurement of unknown inductance which quality factor is more than 10. Okay. So Hayes bridge is used to measure the unknown inductor of a coil who is having quality factor greater than 10. Okay. This is the limitations of Hayes bridge. Okay, so now we will draw the phasor diagram. So first of all, we will see, if we will observe path A, B, C, this path is totally inductive. Okay, and if we will observe path A, D, C, so this path is capacitive. So this current I1 at a balance condition, this current I1 is nothing but lagging with supply voltage E. And the I2 current is leading with supply voltage E. So to draw the phasor diagram, we will take E as a reference. Okay. So I1 current will be lagging because ABC path is inductive. Okay. And I2 current, as this path is capacitive, so I2 current is leading with supply voltage E. So this is the leading, okay, I2 with supply voltage E. So first I1 current is flowing through, I1 current is flowing through Rx then Lx. So draw these two voltage drops. So this one is up to here, I1 into Rx, okay, in phase with current, resistive drop. And then 90 degree, okay, then 90 degree will be the inductive drop. So this is I1 omega Lx, okay. Then this I1 current is flowing through again resistor, so will be in phase with current. So this is, okay, this one and this one in phase, okay. So this one is your I1 R3. Okay, now come to what will happen about I2. So I2 current is going through R2. So first of all, so this is I2. This is I2 R2 drop in phase with current. After that, again R4, again inductive drop, resistive drop. This one is I2 R4. Okay, then again, Then again here capacitive drop. So capacitive drop will be at 90 degree. Okay. Capacitive drop at will be at 90 degree. So this is the 90 degree. Okay, this is the 90 degree. So this is I2 by omega C4. Okay, this one. Okay, so this is the IC by R4, this one. So again, this drop and this drop is nothing but E, and this drop plus this drop plus this drop is nothing but E. Okay, so this is the phasor diagram of Hayes bridge. Okay, thank you.